बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। आई एम एहतराम बीबी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, कोहार्ट यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, कोहार्ट। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द फर्स्ट ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ मेडिसिनल केमिस्ट्री ऑन टॉपिक इंट्रोडक्शन टू एंटी मलेरियल ड्रग्स, एंड आई विल स्पेसिफिकली टॉक टुडे अबाउट सिंफोना अल्कलाइड्स। आउटलाइन ऑफ टुडे लेक्चर इंक्लूड इंट्रोडक्शन टू एंटी मलेरियल ड्रग, classification of anti-malarial drugs, general structure of cinchona alkaloids, properties of quinine and quinidine, which are the active cinchona alkaloid, structure activity relationship and mechanism of action of quinine and quinidine, and at the end I will talk about the therapeutic application and adverse side effect of cinchona alkaloids. Learning outcome: at the end of this lecture, every student will have the knowledge of cinchona alkaloid as anti-malarial drug. Now, what is anti-malarial drug? The medicines which are used for the treatment of malaria are known as anti-malarial drugs. Now, what is malaria? Malaria is a parasitic disease and it can cause million deaths each year. Now, which parasite causes this disease? The parasite which is causes this disease is known as Plasmodium parasite. And four species of Plasmodium cause malaria. It include Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium malaria, and Plasmodium aulae. And these parasites are transmitted by female Anopheles mosquito. Among these four species of Plasmodium, the Plasmodium falciparum is the most dangerous species, and it is generally characterized by persistent high fever and cause death if treatment is delayed. This is the basic symptoms that for the Plasmodium falciparum infected person. And the other common symptoms of malaria include central headache, systematic fever, which means that the fever may be repeated after 4 hours or maybe after 24 hours. Besides these, muscular fatigue, back pain, skin chill and sweating is the particular symptom of malaria. Besides these, some respiratory problems such as dry cough, and have some stomach problems such as nausea and vomiting. To recover a person from this type of disease, several types of anti-malarial drugs are available in the market. And the anti-malarial drugs which are active against Plasmodium falciparum are considered to be the most effective anti-malarial drug. So we will discuss only about those anti-malarial drugs which are included in your syllabus. So your syllabus include 7 classes of anti-malarial drugs, and the first class is 4-aminoquinoline. This is the structure of 4-aminoquinoline. It consists of a quinoline unit. This is a quinoline unit which consists of a benzene ring fused with a pyridine ring, and at pole position is the amine group. So this is the general structure of 4-aminoquinoline, and it have anti-malarial activity, and its anti-malarial activity can be intensified when we substitute this nitrogen with other alkyl and aryl groups. So we obtain its other derivative, aminoquinoline, and which have a good anti-malarial activity. The second class is 8-aminoquinoline, and this is the structure of 8-aminoquinoline, that it consists of the basic quinoline unit, and at 8 position is an amine group. It have also anti-malarial activity, but when we substituted this nitrogen with any other alkyl or aryl group, then we obtain its derivative, and it have more potent than this 8-aminoquinoline molecule. The third class is 9-aminoacridine. This is the structure of 9-aminoacridine, which consists of a basic quinoline unit fused with another benzene unit. And at 9 position is the amine group present. So therefore, this molecule is known as 9-aminoacridine. And when we substituted this 9-aminoacridine at various carbon atom here, or we substituted this nitrogen with other alkyl or aryl group or any other substituent, then we obtain its derivative, which have excellent anti-malarial activity. The fourth class is bigunide, and this is the open chain compound. This is the structure of bigunides, and it's derivative of the gunides, two molecule of gunides combined. So therefore, it is known as bigunides. And when we substituted this nitrogen with other alkyl or aryl group, this one and this nitrogen with other alkyl and aryl group, we obtain its derivative, which have good anti-malarial activity. The fifth class is pyrimidine analog. This is the structure of pyrimidine. And when we substituted pyrimidine at a 2 position, 4 position, 5 position, and 6 position with various substituents, we obtain its different analog, which have good anti-malarial activity. The next class is meploquine. This is the structure of meploquine. And it also consists of the basic quinoline unit. And the quinoline unit is substituted at its 2 position and 8 position with trifluoromethyl substituent. And at 4 position, it is substituted with this alcohol and piperidine ring. And this molecule, meploquine, have also excellent anti-malarial activity. The last and the most important class of anti-malarial drugs are cinchona alkaloids. And this is the general structure of cinchona alkaloids. When we substituted this R1 group and R2 group, when we substituted it differently, we obtained different cinchona alkaloids, which are active against malaria. So today lecture is about the cinchona alkaloids. But we will discuss all these classes one by one, and we will study these classes in a specific sequence. And I have arranged these anti-malarial drugs on the date of their date of discovery. So here is the classification. So the first class of anti-malarial drug is the cinchona alkaloids, and the example of cinchona alkaloids which are used as an anti-malarial drug are quinine and quinidine. And this is the first anti-malarial drug which were used for the treatment of malaria. An example is quinine and quinidine, which was extracted in 1820 from the tree of cinchona. So quinine is the first anti-malarial drug. The second class is 8-aminoquinoline. An example of anti-malarial drug of 8-aminoquinoline is pimaquine, which was synthesized in 1924 after a century of the discovery of quinine, because quinine extracted from the tree in 1820, and then in 1924, the first anti-malarial drug was synthesized, that is pimaquine, and then other pimaquine and tipmaquine were synthesized, which are also derivatives of 8-aminoquinoline. The third class is the 9-aminoacridine. An example of anti-malarial drugs of 9-aminoacridine include quinacrine, which was synthesized in 1930, and the second example is azacrine. The fourth class is 4-aminoquinoline. An example of 4-aminoquinoline are chloroquine, which was synthesized in 1934, and hydroxychloroquine. This class of anti-malarial drugs seems to be more important, because the doctor prescribed chloroquine and hydroxychloroquine for the treatment of COVID-19 too. So it means that these anti-malarial drugs have antiviral activity too. The fifth class is biguanides. An example of anti-malarial drugs of biguanides include proguanil, which was synthesized in 1945. And the other example is chloroguanide. The sixth class is pyrimidine analog. An example of pyrimidine analog of anti-malarial drugs include pyrimidine, which was synthesized in 1952. And the second example is trimethoprim. The seventh and last class of anti-malarial drugs which are included in our syllabus is quinoline menthol. An example of quinoline menthol is meploquine, which was synthesized in 1917. So these are the seven classes of anti-malarial drugs which are included in our syllabus. But besides these, there are other several classes of anti-malarial drugs that are available in the market. But we will discuss only these seven classes of anti-malarial drug. And today lecture is about cinchona alkaloids. So I will discuss these cinchona alkaloids in today lecture. So what are cinchona alkaloids? So before starting cinchona alkaloids, just to let you know that what are alkaloids? Alkaloids are the class of naturally occurring organic compound that mostly contain basic nitrogen atom. Now, this is the structure of nicotine. This is a basic natural alkaloid. It consists of this basic nitrogen atom. I missed one of the nitrogen here. So here is also a nitrogen atom in the nicotine structure. It consists of basic nitrogen atom. So nicotine is an alkaloid because it consists of basic nitrogen atom. And the second class is quinoline, that it also consists of a basic nitrogen atom and it's naturally occurring compound. It is basic because the lone pair of nitrogen take easily proton from the solution. So it is basic in nature. So alkaloids are the naturally occurring compound such as nicotine and quinoline, which consists of basic nitrogen atom. Some synthetic compound of similar structure may also be termed as alkaloids. For example, here we can see the structure of procaine. It also consists of basic nitrogen here and basic nitrogen here. So this type of alkaloids are synthetic alkaloids, and these quinoline and nicotine are naturally occurring synthetic alkaloids. Now, what are cinchona alkaloids? The alkaloid extracted from the plant of cinchona are known as cinchona alkaloids. So the basic nitrogen containing compound which are extracted from the cinchona plant are known as cinchona alkaloids. Now cinchona is a genus of flowering plant in the family Robiaceae containing at least 23 species of trees and shrubs. But not all these 23 species of trees contain alkaloids which are active against malaria. The amount of alkaline present in any tree depends on the species. For example, I mentioned here two species which are rich in alkaloids which are active against malaria. The second point factor is environment of the tree. The third factor is age of the tree and methods of bark collection. This is the image of cinchona alkaloid tree and this is the cinchona bark. This bark contains various alkaloids. And some of them are active against malaria. So it is mentioned over here that the bark of cinchona is the source of variety of alkaloid. But the most familiar which are active against malaria are quinine, quinidine, cinchonine, dihydroquinine, dihydroquinidine, and cinchonidine. So we will discuss the general structure of these cinchona alkaloids now. General structure of cinchona alkaloid is mentioned over here. And the first alkaloids which are active against malaria are quinine and quinidine molecule. And in this case, the R1 is a vinyl group. Here, we substituted a vinyl group. And if the R2 group is substituted with a methoxy group, then we will obtain quinine and quinidine molecule. Both have the same substituent, but they are only different in the stereogenic center at position 8 and at position 9. So therefore, these two molecules, quinine and quinidine, are the stereoisomer. Here is the structure of quinine molecule. We can see that R1 is a vinyl group. It is mentioned over here that the R1 is substituted with a vinyl group. And the R2 group is a methoxy group. Here, we substituted a methoxy group. So it is a quinine molecule. And in this quinine molecule, this 8 center is S and this 9 center is R. And this is the structure of quinidine molecule. The substituent are same. Here R1 is a vinyl group and R2 is a methoxy group. But only the stereogenic center are different. Here the 8 center is R and the 9 center is S. So both these quinine and quinidine molecule are active against malaria and they are only different in the position of their stereogenic center at position 8 and at position 9, while the substituent for both for the quinine and quinidine are the same. The second alkaloids which are active against malaria is cinchonine and cinchonidine. And in this case, the R1 is vinyl, similar to the quinine molecule when we substituted this R1 with a vinyl group, and R2 with a hydrogen instead of methoxy. If we put here a hydrogen and here a vinyl group, then we will obtain the cinchonine antimalarial drug. And the second example is cinchonidine. And cinchonine and cinchonidine have the same substituent, vinyl and hydrogen, but they are also stereoisomers and they are only different at position 8, at 9, at its stereogenic center. The third example of cinchona alkaloids which are active against malaria are the dihydroquinine and dihydroquinidine molecule. And these two are also stereoisomers. And in this case, R1 is an ethyl group. This R1 is an ethyl group. Simply, we saturated this vinyl group, so we will obtain an ethyl group. So if we substituted R1 as an ethyl group, and R2 is methoxy group similar to quinine molecule, then we will call this molecule dihydroquinine molecule. And the dihydroquinidine molecule is the stereoisomer of dihydroquinine molecule, which are only different at the stereogenic center 8 and 9. Among these alkaloids, the quinine and quinidine molecule are the more active anti-malarial alkaloid. So we will discuss next about the quinine and quinidine molecule in detail. General properties of quinine. This is the structure of quinine. Quinine is a white crystalline solid. It melts at 177 degrees centigrade. It is generally very bitter in taste. It is insoluble in water. Quinine is basic amine and is usually provided as a salt because salt are soluble in water. So in the market, it is generally available in the form of hydrochloride, sulfate, and bisulfate. Quinine was first isolated in 1920 from the bark of cinchona tree. Now we will this is the general property of quinine molecule. As quinine and quinidine molecule are the stereoisomer, therefore the physical properties of quinine and quinidine are similar. Only as these are stereoisomers, these have all physical properties similar, but they are only different in their interaction with other chiral molecule. So quinine and quinidine have similar physical properties. Now I will discuss about the structure activity relationship of quinine. So this is the structure of quinine molecule. So for anti-malarial activity, the basic unit of quinoline is compulsory. This, which is highlighted in blue, this is the quinoline unit, and this is compulsory for the anti-malarial activity. And we can increase the anti-malarial activity if we substitute this methoxy group with any other halogen atom. This is at position 6. We can see this is position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So at position 6, if this methoxy group is replaced with a halogen, specifically with chlorine, then we enhance the anti-malarial activity of quinine molecule. Secondly, it was discovered that if we block this position 2 of the quinoline molecule with trifluoromethyl group, then with the anti-malarial activity increase. So it is mentioned over here that it was discovered that increased activity without phototoxicity could be attained by blocking position 2 of the quinoline with a trifluoromethyl group. So if we substitute here a CF3 group, trifluoromethyl group, we will increase the anti-malarial activity of quinine molecule. The third point is that this is carbon 8, and this stereogenic center must be S to have the maximum anti-malarial activity. If we change this stereogenic center to R, then we will obtain the quinidine molecule, which are less potent than quinine molecule. So this stereogenic center at position 8 must be S for the maximum anti-malarial activity. Next is that we can see that here are two stereogenic center at position 3 and at position 4. So the asymmetry of these 3 and 4 position are not essential for the anti-malarial activity of quinine molecule. Whether these stereogenic are R or S, at this position it is S or R, it doesn't matter because it's not essential for the anti-malarial activity of quinine molecule. Next is that if we saturate this vinyl group, then we obtain an ethyl group here, and this will increase the activity of the quinine molecule, but along with activity, the toxicity will also be increased. So it is mentioned over here that saturation of vinyl group at position 3 of this ring increase the activity as well as toxicity of molecule. So therefore, it is recommended to not saturate this molecule. The vinyl group here show maximum activity, because when we saturate this, we increase the activity of this molecule, but the toxicity is also increased. So therefore, it is recommended to not saturate this vinyl group. Next is, this is position 9, and it consists of a secondary alcohol, and this stereogenic center is R. And it's compulsory that it have a secondary alcohol. If we oxidize it to and convert it to a ketone or strip this, then the anti-malarial activity decreases. So secondary alcohol is compulsory for the maximum activity of quinine malicole. So this is all about the structure activity relationship of quinine malicole. Now I will discuss about the mechanism of action of quinine malicole. So the mechanism of action is the interference with the parasite ability to digest hemoglobin. The parasite use hemoglobin for the synthesis of essential amino acid for themselves. So it is mentioned over here that the parasite use globin, utilize globin by malaria parasite to produce essential amino acid for themselves. While doing this, they convert hemoglobin to heme molecule. These heme molecules are highly toxic for the plasmodium parasite. Then the plasmodium parasite convert these heme molecule to hemazone. This is what I mentioned over here. Then the plasmodium parasite polymerize heme molecules to hemazone. And this is not toxic for the parasite. So what is the role of quinine and quinidine? That quinine stops the polymerization of heme molecule. When its polymerization stops, these heme molecules are highly toxic for the parasite. So it stops and kills the parasite. And the host cell is free from the parasite and recover from the disease of malaria. Next is the therapeutic uses of quinine and quinidine. Before World War II, quinine was the drug of choice for the treatment of malaria because it was active against the most dangerous species, Plasmodium falciparum. But nowadays, its use is largely suppressed due to the development of synthetic anti-malarial drugs. However, it is still used in the third world countries in the area where the organism is now resistant to the chloroquine and other synthetic anti-malarial drug. Besides malaria, quinine is also used for the treatment of night cramp in the elderly. Quinidine has the similar effect as quinine. It is used as an anti-malarial drug and like quinine, effective against chloroquine-resistant organism. Now, what are the main side effects of quinine and quinidine? So these are the common side effects of quinine and quinidine. Headache, nausea, diarrhea, and hypoglycemia can occur both in children and adults are common when the drug level are in the therapeutic range. And the overdose of quinine and quinidine result in temporary loss of hearing, ringing in the ear, impaired sight. So these symptoms are known as synconism. So synconism is the side effect of synconalkaloids, quinine and quinidine, which include temporary loss of hearing, ringing in the ear, and impaired sight. So this is known as synconism. Besides these side effects, the most dangerous side effects is that both quinine and quinidine induce cardiotoxicity, which is the main cause of death in overdose. Now, learning factors, here are some learning questions. And for this structure of quinine, you have to encircle each carbon atom, which results in decrease of anti-malarial activity. I mean that when we will change any substituent, then encircle only that carbon atom, that if we change the substituent or if we saturate it, then if the anti-malarial activity is decreased, then encircle all those center which alter the anti-malarial activity of this quinine molecule. Second question is that put the substituent R1 and R2 to obtain the synconine and dihydroquinine anti-malarial drug. Mechanism, don't forget mechanism of action, that it stop the digestion of hemoglobin. And be remember that what is synconism. Summary of today's lecture, we have studied in detail the anti-malarial drugs and its classification, and study in detail the synconalkaloids, properties of synconalkaloids, structure activity relationship, mechanism of action, therapeutic application, as well as side effect of synconalkaloids. Here are some reference books for further reading. Thank you.